With MIP 2.0, the podcast, and always remember, gentlemen, it's a motherfucking movie. So, hold on, before we get into it, I'm gonna turn the light off in the kitchen. So, bear with me. Okay. So today we're gonna get straight into the video. We're gonna be talking about how does it feel to be slept on? You know, a lot of us, to be slept on is meaning that people not expecting you to do anything, you know. People are not expecting you to prosper. People not expecting you to be the one who... People are not expecting you to be the one to set the family straight, you know. And I'm here to tell you that it's okay to be slept on, you know. When you're being slept on, it means that you're low on the radar, you know. You're low on people's radar. They're not worried about you. You know, they're not thinking you're a liability. They're not thinking you're a issue. They're not thinking anything about you. You know, so it's good to be for people not to notice you. You know, and I don't know about other people, but, you know, sometimes you feel like you're invisible. You know, people who are slept on, they feel like they're invisible. They feel like people don't notice them. They're not really in the in crowd. They a lot of us never been in the in crowd. A lot of us we wish to be on the in crowd. We wish to have all the beautiful women, you know, but, you know, they slept on us, you know. They was like, oh, you know, he ain't nobody, you know, he ain't nobody in particular. He's just like everybody else, you know. And this is good to be slept on because you're low on the radar. You know, you're low on people's radar. You're just the average guy with nothing going on. But I'm here to tell you that you are more than the average guy. And you do more than the A-plus students. You do more than the B-plus students. You know, you made D's, F's. And some of your classes, you graduated with the help of the Lord, you know, and people, you know, they kind of counted you out, you know, they kind of thought that this guy is a nobody. We hear it all the time with black women. This dude, he's a dusty, you know. This man, you know, he ain't got no money, he ain't nothing. And it's good to be slept on. And I'm gonna get into that in a minute. You know, a lot of people misvalue people. You know, a lot of us, we get out here and we misvalue each other, you know, based off now. You know, how can, it's just like we're in high school. If we were in high school and I tried to value somebody, if somebody tried to value somebody and they value off of now, meaning they talked about your shoes, they talked about your hair, talked about your home life, you know, they slept on you. You know, they tried to keep you out of the in crowd. You know, the girls thought that you was the girls thought that you was not that dude. You know, a lot of people think that you're not that guy. You know, they're sleeping on you. You know, and when people sleep on you, it could be a good thing. You know, we're going to get into that. But it could also be a bad thing, you know. But if you take the, if you strive and you notice that, you know, you can't, you could do so many things and time, you know what I'm saying? Like, in due time. You know, in due time, everybody will see. In due time, I'm going to be proud of myself. You know, I'm going to be proud of what I put forth in the world. You know, a lot of people sleep on you. And for the people who let it get to them when people sleep on them, you know, you got a lot of people who are attention hungry, you know. And when people sleep on them, they try to go and fit in with those people, and then you just end up being the laughing stock out of everybody. You know, so it's not wise to, if they're sleeping on you, and you know they sleeping, and, you know, they don't take you seriously, it's best to stay in your own lane and not try to act like you guys are cool or whatever, you know. But they slept on you. People, you didn't work with people, you know, and they thought that they was destroying you. They thought that they, your associates, you know, you probably had an issue with somebody on the job, and they thought that they just knocked you off, and they slept on you. You know, people in the neighborhood, you know what I'm saying? Guys in the neighborhood who be on the streets, you know what I'm saying? And they think they're cool, you know, who be selling drugs in the same spot. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, bro, y'all be in the same spot every day doing the same thing, you know? So it's good when people sleep on you. And I'm saying that because you can build more. You see, the people who always been in the in crowd, you know what I'm saying? People who always been in the in crowd and stuff, they had a certain image to portray and stuff, so they can't really focus as much as you can. You know, so when they sleeping on you, like, and they calling you broke, they calling you a joke, they calling you the laughing stock of the neighborhood, you know, that's when you, man, thumbs up this video, man. We got four people in here. That hit the thumbs up button. Hit the thumbs up, guys. Show some love. You know what I'm saying? Live chat is on. Live chat is on. Okay. Thumbs up or thumbs up. It's all good. You know. But the thumbs up button is right underneath the video. It takes 1 second. Hit the thumbs up and I'm going to continue with the message. If you guys don't hit the thumbs up, then I'm just going to talk about some BS. You know what I'm saying? Like, and we're not going to get to where I was, like, Like, why is it good for people to sleep on you? You know what I'm saying? They hit the thumbs up button. God, we got three faithful people in here. Hit the thumbs up. Let me know where you from. You know what I'm saying? The live chat is on. You guys just got in here. Make sure you guys thumbs up this video. Like, share, and subscribe. It's live. You know, share this live, man. This needs to reach the forgotten people. You know what I'm saying? The people who feels like they're all alone. You know what I'm saying? Like I used to feel all alone. Thank you, brother. Lori 666 said, love your channel, brother. I appreciate you. Thank you, Lori. This is for the people who feels all alone. Okay. So, when people sleep on you, you know, this can be the best opportunity for you to exhale yourself, to try to reach different levels, different limits. Try to, you know, while they're sleeping and they're partying, you know, you're hitting the gym, you know. And this is coming from a guy who smokes cigarettes. And I'm not in the gym. I'm going to try, guys. I know y'all been talking about my weight and stuff. You know, yeah, a lot of people been going in on me and stuff like that. But this is a good time for you to think about your health. You know, think about your health and think about the future. So while they're sleeping on you, you're going to want to make goals. You're going to want to make goals. What can I do to leave a lasting impact on for myself personally? Because if you leave an impact for yourself, if you do something and prove to yourself that you could do something, other people will naturally see this. You know, it's at times where I done outgrown. I was a child, you know. I was a child in Memphis, and I outgrown my uncles, and I was a baby, like lost, you know, lost in the sauce, raised by a single mother, two-parent household, you know, well, not a two-parent household, grandmother, granddaddy. Those was the only two people who was together. My dad was in the military, you know, so later in my life, I got with him and stuff, you know, so I got both of both worlds. But I remember being a child and seeing everybody, you know, seeing what people valued, seeing what they did, why everybody's sleeping in their own world. All people have a right to be in their own world, but when they sleep on you, this is the time for you to exhale. This is the time for you to be working 40 hours a week. This is the time for you to be working the extra 20 hours on top of the 40. You know what I'm saying? This is the time for you to clean up your credit or establish your credit. And then I end up excelling aunties, uncles. You know, I went to my hometown and with my little Jeep, like compared to Memphis and the guys in my hometown, like my car was nice. And people treated it like it was like, oh my God, like that's Junior. You know what I'm saying? Like, I done XL everybody. You know, and it comes with, you know, a lot of people be on the BS. You know, a lot of people out here don't know where they're going, don't know how to get there, you know. And especially in poor communities, guys. You know what I'm saying? Like, I was raised in a poor community. I was raised in a black Memphis, where I'm from, was black. I left Memphis. The first time I left Memphis, I was 15. And then I moved to Cali with my father, who was in the military. And the streets had a hold on me, and the narrative of the streets had a hold on me. So I got to Cali, and it's crazy how at a young age, like, you could be so wanting to be Tupac so bad, you know what I'm saying? Like, and I got out there, got with guys with who had pounds of weed, Mexicans, right? Tijuana's right there, you know. And I was getting fronted pounds of marijuana from, like, the Cartez dude. And one day I got robbed, you know what I'm saying, for the marijuana. But, yeah. But what I'm saying is, Memphis is a poor place, and poor places, and if you're in a poor place, then you're gonna have a lot of time fighting lies, fighting everybody's ideals, you know. So first of all, you don't want to get into other people's ideals. You don't want to get into trying to tell them that you're wrong about this, you know what I'm saying, when you're in poor places, because people can get very offensive and jealous and envious, and they can get violent, you know what I'm saying? Like, so, but while they're sleeping on you and they're going around watching Love and Hip Hop, going out to the club every day, you know, every weekend, the females that you used to have eyes for, a lot of people in poor places have a toxic mindset. Those are facts. Capers is in the building. Yeah, that is absolutely a fact. A lot of people in poor places, and a lot of rich places as well, because there's poor people in rich places. So you will see, because I've been off and on homeless for over 10 years. So you can go to a place like Atlanta, and it's an up and coming rich place, but still, like, if you're on the bus and you're on a train, you're gonna run into all different types of poor-minded people, you know. So when you're in a situation like that, let people sleep on you. That's what I'm saying. When people sleep on you, it's good sometimes. Let people sleep on you, and let them talk all the talk they want to talk, and all the ideas, you know, you'll know who to correct, and you'll know who not to correct, you know. Like, if I see a young brother or sister out there that's in need, you know, so a young person that's in need, you know, and I could tell that they just looking for answers, then I tell them what's real. But if I know you and I see you a lot, and you gang banging, you in too deep. You gang banging, you got a hot head, you always talking about robbing people, selling drugs. I'm gonna keep that to myself. You know, you wanna let people know less as possible about you. And this is how you win the race, you know. You can win the race. You can make the impossible possible. Like, nobody thought that they can do it. I remember when people used to say, Chinese, the Asian people and the Mexican people come over here and get loans, and the government getting them businesses and stuff. That's one of the biggest fucking lies. That's one of the biggest fucking lies in the world. Like, first of all, Asian people been here since the colonizing of America, you know. And a lot of people, when they come from other countries, they tend to go to work. And they're not as, even though they're poor, they're not as violent to each other. And they stick together a lot more when they're in another place, you know. So I heard that lie my whole life growing up. That's what I'm saying. Like, people be thinking I'll just be saying stuff. Like, they talk about the Asian people, they give them, I'm like, these folks go get a secure credit card and they build a credit, and it's easy, and that shit'll go up fast. They're not just giving out credit cards like they used to. You have to establish it first. And a lot of times, these people, they'll go work at McDonald's, hotels. then they network with other people, and then they get higher paying jobs. Most of them have better work ethics. Capers is in the building. You're absolutely right. Most of them do have better work ethics. And I understand, like, when you're in poor places, like, the poor mentality spreads to the jobs, too. And I know that's why a lot of you guys be thinking it's slavery, is this, is that. A lot of the managers be poor-minded people, you know. But let me tell you, you do not have to work for them. It's not slavery. You can go and find a job that fits your schedule, that fits your lifestyle. You know, I done been on jobs where people just gossip and rumors, you know what I'm saying? Like high school kiddie stuff. You know, you don't want to, when people sleeping on you, you don't want to be in an environment like that. You want to be in an environment where you can continue to thrive, you know. And if they did do that and you had a plan, you'd be like, okay, I'm going to stay and keep getting money here until I get something better, then you got to be strong-minded to let that go in one ear and not the other. You just do your job and go home. Them 8 hours will go by, but a lot of people make them 8 hours seem like 16 hours because they consistently talk. I can't stand being on a job and somebody looking at the clock all day and talking about, dang, it's 10, ain't number 10 o'clock, man. I know you guys have heard guys say this. Like that's the poor-minded mindset. Like, what else do you have to do that's that important? A lot of guys be chasing behind these women, and a lot of women be not wanting to work. A lot of you ladies do not want to. You guys get these hard jobs in the warehouse, and you guys don't want to work. You know, and the man want to chase you. You know, the man want to chase you around and make sure you ain't cheating on them, which, you know, they'll never figure out if he was or wasn't, you know. It's crazy, you know. You got guys out here who look at working a job as worse than selling drugs. They really sell drugs than work a job. You know, when it's proven that you can make way more money working a job, and it's legit. You ain't got to worry about the police pulling you over because you got a couple of ounces of cocaine in a car. You ain't got to worry about somebody robbing you. You know, the drug game is a whole nother world. Like, because you're illegal. You know that you're illegal. You can't call the police talking about, oh, he didn't rob me for my drugs. You know, and they got guys out there, especially where I'm from in Memphis, who exploit drug dealers. Who will rob a fake, if you ain't street, they will get you. So, so we gonna the comment line is open. You guys can leave comments. It's getting late. I'm on my 12-day working schedule for the month. So I got I work 7 days straight. So now I got 5 more days. And then I can take a fucking break. I gotta get up early, you know what I'm saying? Like, yo, let people sleep on you and keep getting their money, you know? Yo. So guys, man, this is all I got for the video today. Anybody got any comments, anything before I leave? But yeah, it's good for people to sleep on you. Like, you know, you can achieve a lot. You don't need people. Like, you might need them in the aspects of you doing business or something and you're trying to sell a product, but you don't need nobody to level up all the way. Like, you'll be there leveled up so far, you know. It's crazy. Like, I never knew I'd be a supervisor. But, guys, man, that's all I got for this video. Make sure you guys like, share, and subscribe. And always remember, fellas, it's a motherfucking movie. I might hit another cigarette before I leave. I might hit one more. I know y'all like this light. We can have a little light show. You know, let's do it. Let's do it. Let's do it. Oh, yeah. I'm going to have people call in to the show, too. We're going to get active, man. Like, for real. Who do we have in the still in the video? We got one person in here. Who are you? How many times have we come to the same place? You know, how many times have we wasted our time? You know, we're wasting our time, man. You know, how many times have people slept on you? They sleeping on you, man. They sleeping. Fuck them. Let's get some money. They're gone while they're sleeping. While they're sleeping, I be grinding. Yeah, get that money, man. Get it. Like, get the money. Like, fuck them. Like, hey, ain't nobody gonna take care of you like you. You know what I'm saying? Like, yo. All right, guys, I'm gonna holler at you on the next video. Over and out.